But in that aren't a lot of these ideas. They're not, it's not, these aren't essentially black and white issues. And when you state them as if they are black and white issues, that's what opens up all these portals of debate and dissent. And there's just, there's quite a few places online where people are upset at you. And quite a few things that you have said in these hour-long eloquent pieces that people have vehemently opposed.
Yeah, and I'm annoyed that it's not more. Like,
really?
I want people.
But don't
who,
you try to stop them?
Stop them? No.
Don't you pull videos down? Don't you like pull videos for copyright infringement and tell people to not make videos?
Oh no! Oh, this just recently happened. So yeah, this is a guy who worked at FDR. There was a troll out there who
FDR Free Domain Radio.
Which is your organization. Yeah, so there was a guy. I'm going to say troll is going to poison the well, right? There was a fellow out there. I think he's a man, a gentleman of trolley persuasion. And he, I do these call-in shows where people call and we talk about sort of philosophy and ideas and whatever, right? And he had gotten some of those calls, and through a means I don't pretend to understand, he had, you know, doxing where you start revealing people's personal information. Mm-hmm. He'd got pictures of their kids. He'd found out where they live. Yeah,
what?
He had just done stuff where he was...
So someone just called in and he got pictures of their kids?
What can I tell you?
Why do you do that?
Can I pretend to know why people do this? No.
When this person called in, but just to elaborate, sorry to interrupt you, but were these people being threatening? Were they criticizing you in some sort of an...
Oh, no. I think we were just having a conversation about something.
So
and
why
then,
was he trying to get this information about their families?
Well, so let's say I called, someone named Bob called in.
Okay.
And then someone took that slice of our conversation and worked like crazy to try and find everything out about Bob and then published videos with pictures of Bob and, pretty personal. So, look, everybody uses my stuff and I don't care about it. And you can do a search on YouTube for my stuff and everybody who said, I'd really like to reuse your stuff, I'm like, hey, go for it, right?
Mm-hmm.
But we had a number of listeners who called in and said, listen, this guy's doing some pretty creepy stuff with my personal info here. I'm not comfortable with it. So we used that mechanism to take that down. It's got nothing to do with copyright or anything like that. I just felt that listeners were being acted against in a negative way, significantly negative way. So... that's what we did. But it's nothing to do with copyright or anything like that. People use my stuff all the time.
That's incredibly bizarre. So was this a scare tactic to threaten people that were criticizing you? Was that?
No. It's a scare tactic to try and get people to not call into my show. Like, so we'll target people who try to call into your show, and then we will start trying to find out personal information about them and so on. And it's only one or two people, and it's only happened once, but that's why we did that. That's why Mike decided to do that thing on YouTube, which I fully agree with. I think it's a terrible use of time, and it's a negative thing to do. And so, no, but people, I mean, if I was interested in taking down people who use my stuff, then why on earth would there be so many of my videos reposted all over YouTube?
You're making things up again, Arnold.
But it worked, Dad.
You're stretching the truth again, and you know it.
Don't be a fibbing, Fran Arnold.
Joseph Smith?
Because a lie is a lie.
It's not a lie!
That was one channel, Steph. That was one of the channels of a few that you gotten taken down. Which one of True Shibe's videos did that? I challenge any Steph bot to show me what True Shib's video did that. They're all back up online now. They're all back up on YouTube. You can find them, point to them, and show me which one. Steph is deliberately lying by omission. He's talking about the one person that he DMCA'd and not the others. And again, YouTube has a privacy flagging system where these videos can be taken down. And those videos would be taken down by this flagging system. And again, he wouldn't have to be using the guns of the state. He could be using a private resolution. He's a fucking hypocrite. Sorry.